I was thinking I could help you with the wedding plans, you know, if you like.
I think Steve's got it all covered, thanks.
Hey, you never said how things went with Eric yesterday.
Yeah, well, let's just say he's not the most agreeable client I ever had.
Well, he's got you over a barrel, so you're gonna have to grit your teeth and get on with it. At least you're not hurting anyone.
Do you guys want Renner brown sauce on your bacon, but is that making you?
Both for me, Taff.
Thanks for the offer, but there's somewhere I need to be.
Since when did you become Little Miss Homemaker? As far as I knew, you couldn't even switch the oven on.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know me. I had to keep busy.
Oh, please. You're more of a snob than I am. And that is saying something.
Hey, I was thinking, why don't we do some fun together tonight? Maybe get the karaoke system out of the loft.
So I promised Marlena McQueen I'd give it a spray tan.
Oh, well, what about this afternoon, then?
And then I'm chocker with wedding stuff. Speaking of which, it's out for this. They come, they go, we
learn these lessons. I'll speak to you in a bit. Okay, bye. Oh, that was Scott. He has been such a giddy kipper since he met that bloke at the Eurovision launch party.
I'm pleased. Do you know, I'm more concerned with how you are, then.
Okay. Some days are better than others.
I was just wondering, I thought it might be helpful if you spoke with Eric.
Why would I want to do that?
Well, might give you some closure.
I don't even want to think about Eric Foster, let alone go and see him. But thanks for the coffee, James. Wow, you okay?
I will be.
You want to do that? I just thought you might like the company.
Oh, going shopping for clothes is up there with the visit to the dentist. I hate it. I'll just walk into the shop and the first thing I like, I'll pick, and that'll be me done.
Well, you don't take after your sister then. Yaz loves nothing more than spending hours looking at stuff, trying everything on, and then not buying a single thing. It drives me to distraction.
That's exactly how my mum's making me feel right now. I just wish she'd chill out rather than all this mollycoddling.
Do you mind if I just stick my bacon? Do you not think your mum's just looking out for you because she cares?
I'm an adult. I don't need anyone to look out for me.
Yeah, I know that, love, but everyone needs someone on the side, don't they? I mean, I'm lucky Juliet's got Pez because I'm not exactly mother of the year, am I?
Well, Juliet knows how much you love her. And she is right about your mum. I know. I just... all this looking out for me is making me feel really hemmed in, you know?
Well, why don't we do something to take your mind off it then?
Like what, Tom?
Well, I don't know. Obviously not clothes shopping. I want to spend some time with my best mate.
You.
I thought you said you were too busy planning your wedding to do anything else.
Coming in here is one of the most important part of those plans.
When I look my best, when I walk down the aisle.
You always look great.
Anna Marie, I'm marrying one of the most suave, sophisticated blokes in the village. And as much as I love him, I've got no intention of being overshadowed on my big day.
How is James, by the way? I know he's not what you'd call a laugh a minute, but I don't think I've seen him crack a smile in ages. So.
I think he's really busy with work. Have you heard anything of Juliet?
Yeah, she rang me the other day, we had a brief chat.
Although I could tell she was only bringing me because Harry made her.
Who can blame her after what I did at her leaving do?
Oh, everyone's entitled to a little blip.
No, Steve. My daughter was going off to Birmingham to have a stem cell transplant, and what do? Get drunk. I wonder she hates me.
Well, she doesn't hate you. You might not be her favourite person right now, but she'll come round.
I hope so.
Oh, she will. I thought Alia would never forgive me when I took Love Cave off series Link, but she did. You know what you need right now? A big hug. Come here.
Not with those sweaty pits, I'd rather pass, thanks.
Not even lifted a dumbbell yet. Get here, give me some sugar.
For your sake, that you've got some good news regarding our little friend Maxine.
Well,
I don't, I'm afraid. I tried my best. Better than my best, in fact. But Maxine is not in the right headspace to visit the man that did what you did to her. Sitting there like a petulant child isn't going to change anything.
I'm not a child.
Maybe we should look at this from a different angle. You know, it might be a good thing.
In what universe could this possibly be a good thing?
Well, if we were to get an appeal, and they were to find out the reason for the visit, that you were planning to manipulate Maxine into thinking you were remorseful, it would add years to your sentence, not reduce them. But as I said, there are other avenues we can go down. Why don't we focus on them?
Sorry if you finish your monologue. Good. Because you just wasted your breath. I sent Maxine the visitor's order this morning.
You did what?
You know, I can't wait to see her.
Have you not listened to a word I've said? She's adamant she won't come.
I suggest you find a way to change her mind. Because if you don't, when your poor little sister takes her last breath, you'll be in here with me. I'm a
lonely soul. This is Juliet's phone. I'm too cool to pick up right now, so, like, leave a message or whatever. Bye!
Hi, love. It's me. I know we had a little chat the other day, but, well, it'd be nice to have like a proper nap with you if you get a minute. I also just want to say how sorry I am for what I did. You got enough going on at the minute, so you know you don't need to be dealing with that, do you? Anyway. Hopefully, I'll speak to you soon. Okay. Love you, bye-bye.